हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। सो टुडेज टॉपिक फॉर द लेक्चर इज द रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव रेड अबाउट द रिलेटिव एटॉमिक मास। सो टुडेज टॉपिक फॉर द रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मॉलिक्यूल। द फर्स्ट टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज व्हाट इज मॉलिक्यूल। हियर आई एम मेंशनिंग दैट when two or more atoms are combined by covalent bond is called molecule। In the junior classes you must have read about the covalent bond and ionic bond। Whenever there is a covalent bond between the joining atoms, that is called a molecule, and whenever there is a ionic bond between the joining ions, that's called formula unit, which I will make you understand in the next lecture। So first of all, when there is a covalent bond between joining atoms, that stands for molecule। What is covalent bond? The interactive force that have been formed by sharing of electrons। Here I am mentioning the attractive force that have been formed by sharing of electrons। A detailed lecture about covalent bond will come in the chapter of chemical bonding in the further lectures। So today's topic is about the relative molecular mass of a particular molecule। I am giving you certain examples of molecule which are having covalent bond। Example are O2, N2, CO2, NH3, H2O, CH4, etc. and etc. So the mass of one molecule is called a molecular mass। So firstly we are talking about relative molecular mass। So what's a relative molecular mass? It is actually the relative molecular mass is it is actually the number of times a single molecule is heavier than, again that's 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope। That's the thing। So it can be represented in the formula way, that is relative molecular mass is equal to the mass of one molecule divided by 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope। It comes out to be like mass of one molecule डिवाइडेड बाय मास ऑफ कार्बन 12 आइसोटोप इनटू 12. अगेन हेयर आई हैव टेकन दिस 12 टू न्यूमरेटर. लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल. आई एम टेकिंग एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड मॉलिक्यूल CO2. व्हाट्स द मास ऑफ कार्बन? इट्स 12 AMU. व्हाट्स द मास ऑफ ऑक्सीजन? इट्स 16 AMU. बट हेयर ऑक्सीजन आर टू इन नंबर. दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई विद टू एंड इट कम्स आउट टू बी टोटल 32 AMU. What next? Mass of CO2. It comes out to be 12 plus 32. You have to add it up. You will get 44 AMU. What does it stands for? That CO2 molecule is 44 times heavier than 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope. Now, let us calculate the 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope. Will be equal to, obviously, the mass of one carbon atom. The mass of one carbon atom divided by 12, and this value comes out to be 1.99. The mass of one carbon atom has been found by spectroscopic methods, and it comes out to be 1.99 into 10 to the power minus 23 divided by 12, and this value comes out to be 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 in grams. So this value is called 1 AMU. That's one atomic mass unit. I have done this thing in the previous lecture also, so I have again attempted this to make you understand the value of 1 AMU. It's 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. So I'm coming back to CO2. Mass of one molecule of CO2 in grams. It comes out to be, it is 44 AMU, and this value comes out to be 44 into, what's the value of 1 AMU? It's 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. Let me calculate this thing for you. It comes out to be, it's 44 into 1.66. It comes out to be 73.04. This is 73.04 into 10 to the power minus 24 ग्राम्स. नाउ दैट्स द एक्चुअल वेट ऑफ वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ CO2 इन ग्राम्स. सो नेक्स्ट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास. आई एम डन विद दिस टॉपिक द रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास. नाउ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास. व्हाट्स दिस थिंग? ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास कैन बी डिफाइंड एज कलेक्टिव वेट ऑफ 6.022 इंटू 10^23 मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ CO2. दैट्स कॉल्ड ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास. एंड वॉट्स दिस नंबर? आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस सॉरी आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑल्सो दैट दैट दिस नंबर इज नेम्ड एज एवोगैड्रोज नंबर इन रिस्पेक्ट टू द साइंटिस्ट हु हैव फाउंड दिस थिंग कॉल्ड अमेडियो एवोगैड्रो. सो द कलेक्टिव वेट ऑफ 6.022 इंटू 10^23 मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ CO2 इज कॉल्ड ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास. सो लेट मी फाइंड द एग्जैक्ट वेट देन. आई एम राइटिंग ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ CO2 विल बी इक्वल टू. नाउ व्हाट्स द वेट ऑफ वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ CO2? दैट्स लेट मी राइट इन द वर्ड्स फर्स्ट. वेट ऑफ वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ CO2 into obviously Avogadro's number. Now what's the weight of one molecule of CO2? We have just found it's 44 into this thing. So I'm applying it over here. It's 44 into 1.66 into 10^-24 into 6.022 into 10^23, and this whole value comes out to be 44 into 0.99, and obviously we are rounding off this 0.9921, so it remains 44 but in grams now. So that's called gram molecular mass of CO2. That's called gram molecular mass of CO2. That comes out to be 44 grams. Now, another point is that this value is called 1 gram molecule also, and I'm again saying that this 1 gram, it is just a name, it is just a word. Please don't confuse this thing with 44 gram. 1 gram is just a name. Now, if I'm talking about 1 gram molecule of CO2, that stands for 44 gram of CO2. I'm coming to some more examples for the molecular weight. Let's talk about CH4. The same weight comes out to be 16. The atomic weight of carbon comes out to be 16. And that of hydrogen is 1. I'm so sorry. The atomic weight of carbon comes out to be 12, And that of hydrogen, it comes out to be 1. And hydrogen are 4 in number. We have to multiply this thing with 4. It comes out to be 16 AMU. And finally, it comes out to be 16 grams. I'm so sorry. Sorry, I wrongly took the atomic weight of carbon to be 16. It's 12. Now, the atomic weight of carbon is 12 plus that of hydrogen is 1 into 4 because hydrogen are 4 in number. Now, it's 12 plus 4 comes out to be 16 AMU. And it comes out to be 16 grams. Now, let's talk about this is methane. Like now I'm giving you the example of let's take ammonia, SNH3. The atomic weight of nitrogen comes out to be 14 and that of hydrogen comes out to be 1, but hydrogen are 3 in number. We're gonna multiply this thing with 3. Now 14 plus 3 comes out to be 17 AMU and finally 17 grams. Now let's talk about a tough one. I'm taking example of urea. What's the molecular formula of urea? It's NH2C double bond O NH2. Now how many nitrogens are there? 1 and 2. The weight of one nitrogen is 14, but we are having how much hydrogen? 2. So it's 2 into 14. Now let's move to carbon. How many carbons are there? 1. So it comes out to be 12 plus. Let's talk about hydrogen. How many hydrogen are there? They are 1 and 2 is 3 and the 4. We are having 4 hydrogen. The mass of 1 hydrogen is 1 into 4 plus. Now let's talk about oxygen. How many oxygen are there? Only 1 plus 16. So the final answer comes out to be 60 AMU and it comes out to be 60 grams. Let me calculate it first. It comes out to be 14 to the 28 plus 12 plus 4 plus 16. Exactly, it comes out to be 60. So that was the topic for today. Hope you all understood the relative molecular mass, and I have taught you the gram molecular mass. This topic is very important. It's going to help you until the last topic of the chemistry. So please do carefully listen to this lecture and do some practice of your own. If you are having some doubts, please put some comments in the comment section of this lecture. So I hope you all understood today's lecture. I have given my phone number on the thumbnail of this lecture. So if any one of you wants to book a paid one-to-one online class to clear doubts, contact me on my phone number. Please like, subscribe and share my channel to maximum number of students. Don't forget to press the subscribe button. Stay blessed.